And the wonderful thing about the fourth book is that it gives us actual guidelines. Actually, I asked God, I was told that there are beings in the universe that are highly evolved or fully awakened. Mm-hmm. And I said, well, if that's true, what's the difference between a fully awakened being and human beings who may be living in an unawakened state? God said, well, I can give you a list of them. Please do. So in fact, God gave me a list of 16 differences between beings who are fully awakened and some humans who may not be fully awakened. So that list actually turns out to be a wonderful guideline that people can use in order to begin behaving, begin acting like highly evolved beings act in their own daily lives.
And can you tell me some of them?
Well, the first one is what I just said a minute ago about in the book. All highly evolved beings, all entities that are fully awakened, understand and embrace the fact that we are all one, that there is only one thing. And they live into that. That is, they construct their whole lives. They make all of their decisions, all of their choices, whether it's political or economic or social or spiritual or educational. Any decision they make as a culture, as a group, as well as individuals, are made within the context of the oneness of all things, that all things are one thing. So they kind of, live in the old way that we used to hear the story of the three musketeers. So these, mm-hmm. It's a wonderful story. And the three musketeers used to say all for one and one for all. Mm-hmm. But these days we live in a different kind of idea. We live in, every man for himself. And, and to the victor go the spoils, which is a very strange and difficult and challenging way for a society to construct itself. Yet that is largely how we have constructed our society. Mm-hmm. Another of the differences between highly evolved beings and human beings who are living in an unawakened state is that highly evolved beings tell the truth all the time about everything. Humans who are unawakened often do not tell the whole truth. Often they actually lie outright. And frequently, interestingly enough, they actually lie even to themselves. That is, they don't even tell themselves the truth. Mm-hmm. So we can tell that we're highly evolved when we begin telling the truth to everyone about everything. There's a third behavior of highly evolved beings that make them different from us. They share everything with everyone. They never fail to share. They don't share just with family members or people who are close to them. They share with everyone. Mm-hmm. Whatever they have is shared with anyone who needs something they may have. They don't give away every single thing they have. They make sure they have enough for themselves. They love themselves enough to make sure they have enough of what they need. But they share whatever they can spare with everyone, not just with friends or family, but with total strangers, anyone who needs help. Those are some of the many ways. And there's a fourth way that intrigues me. A fourth difference between highly evolved beings and human beings is that highly evolved beings see what works. That is, they look to see what is effective in their life. And they do what works. They see what's true and they do what works. Human beings see what's true and they often do what does not work. Example, human beings see clearly that it's true that smoking is not good for your health, but they go ahead and do it anyway. They see that what's true is that putting small children in front of video games or movies or television programs where there's lots of violence does not work, because it gives children the impression that violence is the way that humanity solves its problems, which of course is true. It is how we solve our problems. But we don't want to teach, at least we don't want to teach our 4 and 6 and 8 and 10-year-olds such a terrible lesson, but we do it anyway. We let them watch video games, play video games where violence is what it's all about, killing each other, and let them watch television programs and movies where there's violence all over the place. So we see what is true, but we don't do what works. In fact, we see what is true and we do the opposite often of what works. So those are four really important differences between beings that are highly evolved and human beings who are living in an unawakened state.